Space, the final frontier. How will the voyages of the Starship Enterprise ever exist without a pursuit in space exploration? In fact, a full-out militarization of our space program is absolutely essential. All civilian efforts will be aimed towards our future militarization. The first scientists to develop the warp drive, functional death beams, artificial gravity, or safe cryogenic slumber will be rewarded with large quantities of live emperor angelfish and a free frozen yogurt coupon valid at certain unspecified frozen yogurt establishments in the greater tri-state area. Construction of an orbital laser platform will be our first priority, followed by colonization of Saturn, Venus, and of course Titan.
Our society is one that is constantly threatened by the existence of other societies. To keep the communists, terrorists, and liberals at bay, gross surveillance of the entire global population is essential. High-definition cameras cleverly disguised as rocks will be scattered throughout civilian homes, businesses, and properties. We will be working 24/7 to keep you safe and secure. Remember to always be polite to your neighbors and obey federal law, because no matter what, we know what you've done.
Sustainability. We have reached a critical point in our development as a species where we must choose a path of self-destruction or self-preservation. The only logical policy for a hopeful future as species is one based in sustainability. Failure to conform will cause what is perhaps a premature death of our human species. Policies will include 100% sustainably produced energy within the next 4 months. We can maybe do it if we try really hard. Complete destruction of all finite fuel resources. I.e. launch them into the sun. This will cause a worldwide shift in energy policy and mindset. Invasion of Australia and or annexation of the Great Barrier Reef. Just try and stop us. For the sake of preservation of species. Begin removal of microplastics from the marine environment via large-scale filtration. And establish an Atlantic bluefin tuna captive breeding program. Tuna is love. Tuna is life.
Hello, I'm Adrien Brody, presidential candidate of the I.S.E.A party. Now, before I go into the history of our party, we're going to take a moment to have our loyal spokesperson, Ms. Rihanna Brunson, present some of the similarities and differences between the Democratic and Republican viewpoints, which are, and at the time of this film's production, the two dominant United States political parties. Now, this is, of course, before my party, the I.S.E.A party, takes control and takes over most of the Western world and then some of the coral reefs that line the East and the Southeast Asian regions of the globe. Now, please enjoy this, and I'll be back with you in a moment.
The Democratic Party believes that we must improve our intelligence here at home. We must reform our intelligence system by creating a true Director of National Intelligence with real control of intelligence personnel and budgets. We must train more analysts in languages spoken by terrorists, and we must break down the old communications barriers between national intelligence and local law enforcement, taking care to fully preserve our liberties. The Republican Party has steadfastly advanced towards the goal of an integrated, unified national intelligence effort. They have reversed devastating cuts in the intelligence community budget and closed dangerous gaps between counterterrorism intelligence collected abroad and at home. They have also broken down the unnecessary wall between intelligence and law enforcement with the Patriot Act. Because it has proven to be instrumental in helping break up terrorist cells and plots and seizing terrorist assets, Republicans believe that Congress needs to reauthorize this important law. The Democratic Party will continue to work with local communities to conserve our publicly owned lands and dramatically expand investments in conserving and restoring forests, grasslands, and wetlands across America. We will ensure that our national parks are protected while expanding opportunities for Americans to visit and experience these national treasures. The Republican Party believes in the moral obligation of the people to be good stewards of the God-given natural beauty and resources of our country. They base environmental policy on several common sense principles. A policy protecting these objectives, however, must balance economic development and private property rights in the short run with conservative goals over the long run. Also, public access to public lands for recreational activities such as hunting, fishing, and recreational shooting should be permitted. The Democratic Party states that the space exploration budget should be consistent with that of the 1990s, while the Republican Party is torn on the issue.
I love space. Love space. Atmosphere. Black holes. Astronauts. Nebulas. Jupiter. The Big Dipper. The Big Dipper!
Hello, it's me again, Adrien Brody. Now, I'm here to tell you about my party's history and why you should vote for us in the next presidential election. Now, on April 4th, 1973, this party was founded by an emperor angelfish by the name of Felix. Now, Felix really admired me. He was in the hospital waiting room, and we've been friends really ever since. And I didn't remember him at the time, but I didn't know he'd really influenced my life so much. Now, we chose the emperor angelfish as our party's mascot because it really represented, the grace and overall semi-aggressive, semi-reef-safe behavior of my party's policies. And I think that really reflects on everyone. Now, I chose Lieutenant Commander Spock in June of 1982 as my faithful and highly logical running mate for obvious reasons. He's a great guy. So that basically wraps up most of the party's history. If you have any further questions, please ask the people presenting this. Okay, goodbye.
Space. 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 Space.